okay, so it's time to actually screw all of the parts together to see whether this thing's going to whether it's going to fit or not. I've got all the parts needed at least to get that part of it done. So obviously jaw kind of pieces, which you've seen, kind of some of the most of the dome pieces. There's one dome piece, which is the piece that comes at the back, kind of here. I haven't printed that one yet, but this will give me more than enough idea as to whether this is whether it's at least kind of close to the right size or not. I'm using screws that I got off of Amazon. I'll put a link up there. This is the pack of screws that I got, and I'm using generally the 2x5s and the 2.3x8s that come out of here. And then obviously just a suitable screwdriver. Even though they're really small screws, the best kind of head seems to be, what is it, like the PZ1 type head. So let's start screwing it together and give it a go. Okay, starting with the two jaw pieces, you do find that if you put, if you just literally start to slot it together from the front and kind of hold it in here, you'll feel that it actually lines up really nicely, and it kind of puts itself into a natural position to be screwed together. So what I've done with the screws in the back here, where are we? Here. So I put the screw in, and then actually kind of gone through all the way through the first panel, and then just threaded it so that it's, you can either put a pilot hole through or just let the screw kind of thread itself, if you know what I mean. That way that it's only going to be biting into the other side, not so much into this side, which makes it a little bit easier to pull together. So yeah, once you push the screw all the way through and you've just got the point sticking out, it locates in the printed hole. And then if you just screw it together, I'm actually using the two by sixes on these. It's just a little bit longer. And again, if you press in that middle section there, it holds it into the right place nicely. And then again, it locates itself into the hole on this side. And then just screw it into place. And so for a test kind of purposes, just those two screws kind of that hold in, seems to kind of hold it in quite nicely. So yeah. That's that section done. Okay, so the cheek sections, they go together like that. And kind of, again, just line up with the bottom and the top area. I've put put the screws through so that they can locate into the little areas. If there isn't a hole there, you just gotta line it up kind of on these edges. Just kind of screw it in. It's not so easy to see. Let's screw those in nice and tight. And it doesn't really matter, I guess, if you kind of just break through, because at the end of the day, you'll be gluing these, and then you'll be kind of, you know, doing filler and fairing and priming anyway. So yeah. Okay, so that's that side done. Same with the other side of the cheek. So obviously, as I say, put two screws in that area there, just to go through, kind of hold it into place. You can see I put the screw ready in for this to be attached to the next to the dome part. So that kind of would go there. And obviously, that bit would slot in there. You don't need that bit for testing as such. Screw it on if you wish. I'm just going to tape mine into position, and then it lets the face sit in that area there. So I'll just kind of tape this in for now, and then we'll see where it goes. Okay, so with the two dome sections going together, you've got this larger section here, which I think is dome two, dome three, dome two. You'll see in the instructions, but or in the file set. So again, put the screw all the way through here so that I can then try and locate it into this hole here. You can see where there's a little marker that it prints in here. So you just got to try and locate the screw into there. I kind of find doing it, looking at it from the underneath is the easiest way to do it. So look at that, and then you'll find that it kind of semi-locates into the hole, and then screw it together. Some of these are a little awkward, but they get there. Okay, so once those two bits are together, next piece is to put the main dome section on the top. That bit will sit on there, obviously screw through tabs, a little awkward, but the same thing, put your screws through so that they poke through, locate the little printed kind of marker holes, and then screw through from there. Okay, sack section done, and then it's just left to bring those two pieces together like that to create kind of the entire, that whole section put together. Okay, so that's all that section all kind of screwed together. Those little ones here for kind of putting the jaw area up onto the helmet here, they're a little awkward. If you've got that kind of screwdriver, if you've got that kind of head, that seems to be the right kind of head, but you do need a stubbier screwdriver just so that you can get your hand in between the two and there, so it just makes it a little less awkward really. But yeah, that's all kind of gone together really quite well, and yeah, let's see how it fits. Okay, so, well, the good news is it does actually go over my head, but it's way too big. I think there's plenty of room in there for another helmet, maybe even. So I'm gonna reprint this at a different scale. I'm gonna do some measuring. Once you've got the helmet, obviously it's a bit easier to do a little bit of measuring, but yeah, it's a little bit kind of bobblehead-esque, if you ask me. Pretty huge, so yeah, I need to do some resizing. So once I've done some resizing and some reprinting and have a look to see, you can see how much room's in there. It's, yeah, quite a lot of room in there. So I'll do some resizing and we'll take a look at it, and I'll do some reverse backwards measuring so that I can see what I potentially did wrong with the sizing ring, and whether I didn't kind of have it fitted right, whether I've just got a completely odd shaped head. But you know, apart from that, it actually looks really, really good. It's really cool. Let's have a look. So yeah, as an actual model and a print, it goes together nicely. Obviously it's just semi screwed together at the minute, just for the sizing and side of things, so gaps will get better, and when it's all kind of filled and everything else, it'll look really good. But yeah, just too big at the minute, so we'll give that a go, see what happens next. Okay, so before I started reprinting, there were a couple of items I wanted to just reposition on the bed slightly differently. Dome 2 was one of them. And that was because I was just having issues down on these areas here where these bits would fall over because of the supports. So what I did was just rotated it and raised this off the bed slightly so that when it did the support on top of the raft, it meant that the support was a little bit higher, and it meant that the model had to be printed on top of the support. So that worked out much, much better. The main dome 1 section. Previously I'd printed this so this was flat on the bed, and these were up in the air. This that part of it all printed fine, but actually down here, as you can see from the picture, was absolutely awful. So we used that obviously as a test bit. I thought it didn't matter, I could probably sand it all back and filler anyway, but because I'm resizing, it doesn't matter. So put this massive blocker up here so that it didn't put a support up here. Pretty confident that the printer could handle going up into that area without any support. But you can see where it did put the support, just down on the sides. And that's just what kind of helped hold it to hold, obviously, this massive overhang here. You needed the support in that area anyway, so you can see that it put it there, but didn't need to put it kind of up into this area, a little bit down there, and that was it. Okay, so I also repositioned the face so that I had more kind of area down here, lower kind of center of gravity, so that supports were down here. Put these blockers up so that it didn't do any large towers. It was stood upright a little bit more. It did put the supports in the eyes this time, just in that area, and you can see where it started to support it over in that area there and down there. So yeah, all good. Okay, so after a little bit more printing, we have a new helmet all screwed together, so you didn't have to go through that rigmarole anymore, and it's much tighter, not uncomfortably tight though, and I think that fits much better, much, much better. So there's definitely room, but it's, and yes, and obviously that sits nicely on the front. And it fits. So, but it's definitely tight kind of on the ears going over. Not overly, but it's kind of semi-tight there. But once it's down and on, it's absolutely fine. I think from a scale perspective, I'm much better. I'm not entirely sure exactly where it might sit with padding and that kind of thing, but you can see that there's much less kind of room going on in there, so yeah, success. And if we put the two together, if I show you down there, there's the original one. That's the new one. So there is yes, a definite difference between the two. Well, there should be, there's about 8%. So yeah, much, much better. So yeah, that's that been done. I've actually got the servo kind of just mounted in there on the plate, just because I wanted to see what room there was kind of with it in there. But now it's, time to screw the servo arms on, put the other plate all together, put that onto face mask, get the Arduino programmed up, and see about how that looks with the retraction system going up and down. So yeah, exciting times. Okay, so I'm back out in the man cave, about to start doing the Arduino wiring and soldering up and doing a bit of coding, but I thought I'd better quickly just go over the scale. So the new scale that I ended up at was 98% from the original. So original, obviously 100%, I went up to 106,
ended up at 98 to get to the helmet that I've drawn. So remember the sizing rings? So this one was the 100%. And as I put it down, it will go. And if I kind of push my ears in, it will slot over my ears quite easily, you know, without any real issues. I thought it needed to be so that they just brushed your ears and was tight on your ears as it went over, which was 106. So that literally kind of just did that. So that was at 106% on that sizing ring. Now I've done the scale, I reprinted the sizing ring again just to see how the sizing ring actually feels, how it actually kind of feels at the percentage. So that's kind of 98%. That's on and tight. I can push my ears in and it'll go over. But it does, it does feel kind of quite tight. So just bear that in mind when you're printing. Print at 100%, see how it feels. This is snug all the way down, and then quite tight over the ears to get to the size that I think is right for me anyway. So bear that in mind when you print your sizing rings. Start 100%, see how it goes. Review this video and have a look and see what you think. So yeah, I'm going to go and do some coding, go and do some wiring. I'll put the links to the screws that I used to put it all together, and yeah, I'll see you when it's all wired.